Hello and welcome to the episode 146 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. The last exclusive BBC session, the recording of Yellow Submarine and the start of the second John and Yoko bed-in for peace are among the highlights of today's episode. Let's get the ball rolling with the fifth date of the Johnny Gentle 1960 Scottish tour. As you might recall, the Silver Beatles were serving as the backing band to the Liverpoolian singer. On the 26th of May, they were on at the Town Hall in force. The Silver Beatles, George Harrison, John Lennon and Paul McCartney on guitar and voice, Tommy Moore on drums and Stu Sutcliffe on bass, had by now exhausted their meager cash reserves. Despite calling tour promoter Larry Parnes every day to ask for their money, they hadn't received any. On this date in 1961, the Beatles, with Pete Best on drums, performed at a top 10 club in Hamburg, West Germany, for their second residency in the city. 1 year later, in 1962, the Beatles were still honoring a residency engagement in Hamburg, this time at the Star Club, and still featured Pete Best in their lineup. On the 26th of May 1963, the Beatles returned to perform live in Liverpool, and specifically at the city's Empire Theatre. This stop of the Roy Orbison package tour was their first engagement in their hometown from their Cavern Club concert of the 12th of April, more than 6 weeks before. If nothing else, it was an indication of how the mounting success of the band would somewhat sever their ties with their city. In 1964, George Harrison and John Lennon, with Patti Boyd and Cynthia Lennon, returned to London from their Tahiti holiday. In 1965, the Beatles were busy at the BBC Piccadilly Studios in London for what turned out to be their 52nd and last exclusive recording session for BBC Radio. Broadcast between 10 a.m. and 12:15 p.m. on the 7th of June as a bank holiday special for Whit Monday, the show was titled The Beatles Invite You to Take a Ticket Ride. The session, taking place between 2:30 and 6 p.m., saw the band performing 7 songs live. Ticket Ride, Everybody's Trying to Be My Baby, I'm a Loser, The Night Before, Honey Don't, Dizzy Miss Lizzie, and She's a Woman. In addition, the band offered the usual jovial chat with the show host, Danny Percy. After the broadcast, the general consensus within the audience was that the Beatles had been featured too little in their own show. On the 26th of May 1966, the Beatles entered the EMI Studios in Abbey Road to record one of their most famous songs, Yellow Submarine. Between 7 p.m. and 1 a.m, the band rehearsed the song extensively before recording 4 takes of the rhythm track featuring George Harrison on tambourine, John Lennon on his Gibson Jumbo acoustic guitar, Paul McCartney on bass, and Ringo Starr on drums. The 4th take was judged good enough to get further work. Ringo's lead vocals plus the backing choirs by George, John and Paul were added to that performance. While the instruments had been recorded with the tape running slightly fast, thus sounding 1 semitone lower on normal playback, the opposite approach was taken while recording the vocals. The tapes were slowed down, and so the resulting singing sounded 1 semitone higher when played at normal speed. Producer George Martin did not attend the session after being sick from food poisoning, but sent his girlfriend, Judy Lockhart Smith, to be a fly on the wall for the session. Finally, in 1969, John Lennon and Yoko Ono checked into the Queen Elizabeth Hotel in Montreal, Canada, on this date, starting their second bed-in happening to promote world peace. A week-long media marathon in which the door of their suite was open to whoever wanted to walk in with a tape recorder, a camera, or a notepad for an interview. The couple had originally wanted to stage the happening in New York, but it had been impossible to get a visa for John Lennon due to his cannabis possession conviction on the 18th of October 1968. In fact, they weren't initially allowed in Canada either. Their stay was possible thanks to a grace period during which their appeal was considered. Every sort of people came during the 8 days of the bed-in with questions about politics, civil rights, peace, the Quebec separatist movement, psychedelic drugs, and so on. The Lennons were also able to enjoy the company of some guests, such as musician Petula Clark, Timothy Leary, American cartoonist Al Capp, members of the Canadian Radha Krishna Temple, black civil rights advocate Dick Gregory, and others. You can get an idea what went on in the video linked in the episode description. This concludes today's episode. Let me remind you to please visit www.simonmas.com/support. As soon as life gives me a chance, I will act upon my plan to make available the deluxe version of this podcast, featuring hours of extra content through NFTs. In the meantime, you can still have a look and find out the many ways in which you can be fab and support this and other music-related content I am plotting. Your help will speed up the production and its distribution on the internet. Tomorrow we'll keep up our busy schedule of looking into the Beatles' history, focusing on a weird video featuring Dylan and Lennon in 1966. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.